Hey! Glad you made it. I'm really happy that you're willing to give this game a shot. It's one of my favourite things to do with friends. Between the role-playing, strategy and just being goofy with each other, it's always a great time. D&D has something for every kind of player. Now, you said the other day that you wanted to just get kind of an intro experience before joining my regular campaign group. So I figured a more individual sort of experience would be a good way of showing you the ropes. Give you an idea of what the experience can feel like. Just take a seat whenever you feel like getting started. I've got snacks that should last us until the end of the universe, so help yourself to those too. Good to go? Okay, so first things first, let's choose your class. I've got the basics already written up for a few of them, so you only need to worry about picking one. Do you want to be a holy warrior with the ability to heal yourself and smite your foes with the power of your deity? Paladin might be the way to go. Oh! Or maybe a wizard, using your magic to blast bad guys sky-high with fireballs while deflecting incoming attacks? But a rogue could be fun too. Hit-and-run tactics, poisoning your enemies and watching them succumb to the venom. So satisfying. But it's also lots of fun to just be a barbarian with a big axe. Barbarians can get so angry that they just kind of forget that they've been hit and keep hacking away. I've always had a hard time choosing when I'm a player, so take your time. Okay, next let's allocate your stats. You want me to explain how stats and dice rolling work in this game? Stats determine what you're good at. Each stat has a use in combat, but they can also apply to role-playing situations and other things you do while adventuring in the world. Whenever you roll the 20-sided die, you'll add whichever stat applies to the roll. So, say you've got a +3 in wisdom and need to see if someone is telling the truth, you would roll the d20 and add 3 to whatever you rolled. That insight check would show how well you're able to read that person's intentions and emotions. Rolling high means you can understand them and see through any lies they might be telling. Rolling low means that you believe whatever they're saying. Within reason, of course. If you roll a 20 on that die, then you'll almost certainly succeed at whatever you're trying to do, or at least get useful info. Let's try an example. You are speaking to a tavern keeper, asking after some local bandits that you've been hired to hunt down. He talks easily enough, but he says that he has no information on these people or where to find them. Okay, you rolled a 10, so add 3 to that. With a 13, you notice him tense and almost physically withdraw when you ask him about the bandits, giving you the sense that he's hiding something and knows more about the situation than he's letting on. That's pretty much it. Rolling a 20 when you hit someone in a fight also counts as a critical hit and doubles how much damage you do to them. Rolling a 1 on that die, though, can be really bad news. Sometimes it just means failing whatever you're doing. Sometimes it means failing so spectacularly that you, I don't know, fall down a flight of stairs, out of a window and into a pen of screaming goats. Okay, probably not that specifically, but you get the idea. Stats determine what you're good at. Each stat has a use in combat, but they can also apply to role-playing situations and other things you do while adventuring in the world. Whenever you roll the 20-sided die, you'll add whichever stat applies to the roll. So, say you've got a +3 in wisdom and need to see if someone is telling the truth. That insight, rolling high, means within reason, of course. Let's try an example. You are speaking to a tavern. Okay, you rolled a 10, so add 3 to that. That's pretty much it. Rolling a 20 when you hit rolling a 1 on that die, though, sometimes it means failing so spectacularly that you, I don't know, fall down a flight of stairs. You'll also see that your class already has stats that will best support their abilities. How you add your extra stat points is up to you. Do you want to make them better at what they already do, or do you want to balance them out a bit? You'll get more stat points to distribute as we play. And like that, you've made your first character. Congrats! Now, how about we dive right into things? The continent of Faerun has seen hundreds of stories turn into legends. The Dawn Age, when dwarves overthrew the tyrannical giants and elves waged war against evil dragons, thereby carving out a place in the world for small folk. The Tyranny of the Rose Dragon, when the great red worm Ylvir of Salisar nearly razed Kalimshan and established her cruel empire. The Time of Troubles, when celestials and fiends alike were cast from their own realms, warring and laying waste to the mortal plane in their efforts to reclaim their divine positions. Yet each great story has great people steering the narrative. The Rose Dragon's empire only fell because Rafak Al-Khazan and his companions slew the evil beast. The Times of Troubles ended because those like the Mage Midnight rose to the occasion, in their case taking the mantle of divinity from the slain celestial Mistra until she could be resurrected. Now we come to the precipice of another such event, a budding calamity that could warp reality as we know it. Though there is no prophesied chosen one, no foreseen savior, if you play your cards right, you might just be able to avert what is to come. Or perhaps your story will simply serve as a cautionary tale for those who survive. Despite this, it all starts with something as mundane as fetching groceries for your parents. We open on Nashkel, a village on the northern slopes of the Cloud Peaks. The late spring rains have abated, making the trek across town to deliver a commission for your father at least a bit less muddy. As you make your way back along the main street, though, it is hard not to notice that your otherwise quiet home is riddled with strained, whispered conversations. Standing behind his produce stand is Eric, one of the farmers living on the village's outskirts. You have known him for most of your life, though he is still young and smile lines have only just begun to crease the sides of his eyes.
Your father said you'd be along to pick up his purchase. I don't envy him his back problems, as if he didn't have enough to deal with already as the headman. Anyhow, here you go. I'm sure he appreciates having you around to do all the heavy lifting for him.
Yeah, old age doesn't seem to agree with him.
Yeah, well, it doesn't with most of us. If you're ever given the option of growing old, don't.
What's everyone whispering about? I only caught a bit.
Everyone's worried about the people who've gone missing. You probably already heard about Helsa not coming home yesterday. That makes the fourth person in 2 weeks. The trackers looking for her haven't come back yet, but if it's anything like the other three disappearances, they won't find anything. People are real frightened. I can't blame them. Might be a good idea to not wander around on your own, even in town.
Fair point. You watch out for yourself, too. Your wife would either break down or start tearing the forest apart looking for you.
Yeah, and then give me a walloping for vanishing on her. But seriously, stay safe until we get this sorted out. Now, get going. I bet your father will be wanting lunch or something soon. Say hello to your mother for me.
Take care, Eric.
See you around.
You hear voices from inside your house. Perhaps it is worth waiting and listening in.
And I just heard about it this morning.
Does anyone else know?
I caught one of the trackers before he could go out to look for Helsa. He said he'd check it out while the trail was still warm, if there was one. But I don't know if he told anyone else first.
We'll have to assume that he did. People are already starting to panic, and this'll make it worse. I heard people at the market this morning talking about unfamiliar monsters. No one had seen the things themselves, but the rumors are bad enough.
This goes on, and you'll have a mob at your front door demanding answers.
I'm surprised you haven't seen one already. You've got to get ahead of this.
So what are you going to do about it?
Give me a minute. I've got an idea, but I want to talk it over with Katra first. You're welcome to stay if you like. They should be back soon.
Ah, there you are. Put the food on the table and come talk to me. There's something we need to discuss. Listen, you've heard about the people going missing. I'm not going to sugarcoat this, but the whole Kelsit family is gone now. Neri found their farm empty this morning without even a sign of struggle. This is asking a lot, and I've got a feeling your mother's going to kill me after I say this.
Then don't say it.
But I need you to go speak with Endon Dravahir and ask for his help.
You're right. I think I will throttle you. Are you insane? People are going missing, and you think sending Katra out into the woods by themselves is somehow a good idea?
I have to agree with Illyn. They'd make a tempting target.
The trackers have been going on their own, and no one's bothered them. Besides, after all the training I've put Katra through, they should be fine on their own.
Yes, but you could just send one of the trackers or someone else.
Thank you.
I want the trackers to keep looking for our people. Other than them, there's no one else I'd trust in the woods more than Katra. After all the times you've run off into there as a kid, you probably know the paths better than most of the villagers. And Vyir is important. His ego probably won't let him talk to just a random villager. Neri could go, but she doesn't know how to fight, and I don't want the community's healer to be missing for a whole day if someone breaks their arm.
And you're not worried what Vyir might do to them?
Unless Katra does something really stupid, which I would trust them not to, they'll be fine.
Mom, if I can help the village, then I'm happy to do it. Besides, I was just in the woods yesterday looking for berries, and I was fine.
I was hoping you'd say that. This isn't exactly an enviable task. I'm proud of you. Now, Endon Dravair is a proud creature. He has the wisdom of the ages and probably knows something that we don't. But there's a good chance he won't help us for free, just on principle. If he doesn't, I want you to offer him money. This pouch has 100 gold coins in it.
100? Where did you get that kind of money?
I took it from the village's emergency fund. I'd say this counts. Rounded it out to 100 using money we were saving for a new roof. Start with a low offer, like 30, and work your way up, unless you think you're gonna insult him or lose his interest. Whatever help or advice he can give will be welcome. If we're lucky, he might already know where our missing people are or where to look. A bird's eye view could show him what we need.
I still think that this is a bad idea.
If I'm being honest, it probably is a bad idea, but it's the only one we've got.
Is there anything else I should know before going?
At this point, you know everything that we do. I wish we could be of more help, but Vyir's home is not far. Hopefully nothing will bother you on the way.
Right. I guess I'll head out now, then.
Before you go, do you want to do a quick sparring match? Couldn't hurt to brush up on your technique, just in case.
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. One more thing. I'm sure you can find your way and don't want me fussing over you. But in case something happens, you should take your father's old wayfinder. Thanks. I'll take good care of it.
Just be careful, and come back in one piece. We'll be waiting for you with some dinner ready.
What is that? Is someone...
Whoa! Stay back! Okay. Wasn't expecting that. I wonder if they got something to do with what's going on.
Guess this is it? Unless this wayfinder led me to some old owlbear den. Okay, then.
As you reach for the coin that seemed to suck the life from Endan Dravaeir, you note a crack running down its face. Whatever these people want with it, you doubt they should have it. The moment you touch the metallic surface, though, a jolt of energy sears through your fingers and up your arm, followed by a sense of pressure, as if the ocean's tide were rushing into your flesh. Recoiling, the coin is adhered to your fingertips, bound there even as you feel that the force pouring from it stretches your skin and crushes your bones, threatening to rupture and burst your entire body. Other than your body, though, it is the coin that bursts, erupting into shards of metal as the same light that flowed into it earlier streams into you. The physical pain abates, though something continues to press on your mind, clawing its way into your thoughts and filling your skull as the world around you distorts and turns insensible, chaotic, and then, finally, dark.
What happened? Where is...
Who are you? What have you done to me?
I don't know.
Answer me.
No, please... Stop! Who are you? What are you doing to me?
Who am... I will ask again. Who are you? What happened to those people in my cave?
Your cave? Who or what are you?
Do not play games, child. I am Endon Dravayer, and you will answer my questions.
Why can I hear you? Where are you?
We are obviously merged, you fool. Now tell me how. What happened?
Did you see anything? I think I was unconscious for a while, but I must have walked to get back here, right?
I only came back to consciousness when you were calling for your parents.
What do you remember?
I remember. They must have trapped my soul in that coin. I have heard of artifacts that can do such. had never expected that it would be so painful, though. It felt like I was being torn and pulled apart, then crushed until I could not even tell what part of my body I was feeling. I suppose, though, that I was not feeling my body at all. After that, I saw the thing seeping out of my body, but I could not see if I was breathing. Everything after is unclear. It hurts to remember. I was still reeling when the next thing I clearly saw was your face. A moment before, I felt that transfer again. Then we were here.